So you join us for the formation lap of the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup final race of their season 2016. The cars are off on their formation lap then for this, the final 25-minute race. And here comes the grid in full for you. Sascha Fenestraz going from P1, Bartlamé P2, James Allen P3, Alex Gill P4, one car not getting away from the start then. Max De Forni goes from P5 with Torian Boccalacci then on P6. P7 is Falchero. Gabriel Aubry from P8. Row 5 contains Robert Schwartzman and the new champion, Lando Norris, who took the championship in the last race. Then we find Bruno Baptista, Alexei Korniev, Will Palmer, Jihan Daruvala, followed by Alex Vartanian and Hugo Di Sadalia. Then row 9 of the grid is Nersis Isakian, Finlay Hutchinson, and row 10 is Lawrence Hua, and Enrique Chavez goes from P20 on the grid. P21 is Hazybrook and Pankovic, and then that is the grid in full for you for this 25-minute Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup race. Track conditions dry, air temperature a balmy, not quite, 16.6 degrees Celsius. So these fine single-seater cars then on their way to the grid, powered, of course, by the Renault Sport engine. And they produce something like, it was 210 brake horsepower, and weigh in at a mere 505 kilograms. So, one car that's not getting away is the car of Enrique Chavez. Thank you. Patrick Simon alongside me, acting as my producer. What a great man he is. Just gelling back his hair as we speak. Yeah, what a pity we don't have a camera in this studio. So then the cars into their grid boxes. Last time out, it was Schwartzman that won from De Forni and Fenestraz, P1, 2 and 3. Robert Schwartzman, I remember from ADAC Formula 4, young diddly little Russian guy who will finish the championship in P5. Which surprises me. I expected him to be further up the order than that. Be interesting to see where he goes next year. Okay, so we await the green flag from the marshal at the rear of the pack. And once we have that, which we do right now, stand by because the start is about to get underway. Throw the lights to the top of the screen and whoa, whoa, whoa. So going exactly when he could, shouldn't, Sascha Fenestraz. So that has actually really caught him out. He's gone back down to much further down the order, played into the hands of everyone else that was around, and thankfully all managing to avoid the fast, then slow-moving car away from the grid. Around the sequence of turns they go now, holding on to everything that they can. So Fenestraz then being penalised, presumably enough, through jumping the start, then realising that he'd done that and stopped, and then lost out on a huge, huge bunch of places. Lots of lock-ups and spin as well as they go through the hairpin here at Hockenheim. And the car spun around. It is the number three car of Robert Schwartzman. Who I was just extolling the virtues of, but he was tapped into that, so now he's going to have a lot of work to do right from the back of the pack. So, as the race leader approaches us now, and goes through our camera position, Sascha Fenestraz absolutely furious with the mistake made at the start, and will really have the bit between teeth now to try and make up those places. But going to have hard work to do because the pace being set at the front is really, really quick. Into the final turn, the Sud Curva. And here they come then to cross the timing line for the first time of asking. So James Allen leading from the number 96 car of Barthélemy Meraki, the BM Racing Team. P3, Alex Gill, Dorian Boccalacci, P9, DeForni is P5, Fenestras is back in at P6, but when you consider where Fenestras started at this front row of the grid, absolute disaster of a start for him. And there you can see in replay, car number 11 is now getting a drive-through penalty for that botched start attempt. So Fenestra's position in P6 is going to be much, much lower than that following the drive-through penalty that he will have to take, having jumped the start. So Alan, then it is that leads. James Allen driving for the JD Motorsport concern. As we look at some of the replays from the opening lap. And that was where Robert Schwarzman was pushed into that by Gabriel Aubry, I think it was, that turned the SMP Racing driver around, supported by SMP Racing. The team, of course, Josef Kaufmann Racing. So Robert Schwarzman then turned around in that little incident. And there, confirmation of the drive-through penalty for car number 11 for jumping the start. And there you can see the Sascha Fenestras car, which is the offending vehicle, which will have to take a drive-through penalty. So that will put him right down the order. So Alan then with a good margin of some 1 second over the P2 car of Barthélemy Meraki, who is running P2, P3. Is the number 27 car of Alex Gill, and then keep your eyes on the car in P4 at the moment. Dorian Boccalacci, as Lando Norris is having a go there. Lando Norris, of course, sealing the championship, is in P7 at the moment. Of course, with the Sascha Fenestras car going to have to take a drive-through penalty. Lando Norris doesn't need to, although he does need to move up the order, and the Fenestras car is the car that's in the way, but now he's going to have the inside line for the next turn, so Lando Norris should have this job done and dusted. Indeed he does. He goes through that car, so Lando Norris moves up to nominally P6 with 20 and a half minutes on the clock remaining in the race. Alan then with a comfortable margin of just over a second over the P2 driver, who locks up just ahead of Alex Gill then, who's running in P3. Through to towards the Südkurve, two corners now. And there is Fenestras, who chooses not to dive into the pit lane on this car. Oh, I beg your pardon. Yes, he does. It wasn't the Fenestras car that we were looking at. So Fenestras comes in to serve his drive-through penalty, and that will put him right to the back of the order. Robert Schwarzman returning from that spin around has got back into the P20 position ahead of the number 94 car of Philippe Hazebrugge. And there you can see Schwarzman. Having to return from that pirouette that he wanted no part of, but ended up being a part of it. Dive up the inside there from Max DeForni. So Max DeForni he's taken a brace of a pair of P2s, and now up against the Boccalacci car goes Lando Norris. So Lando Norris in the white and red, and Boccalacci then in the black and red colours. Just wonder whether the front nose of Lando Norris's car just looked a bit loose there, whether that was wobbling around. There was a tag in the opening lap or not for Lando Norris. This in replay then. Max DeForni on the Boccalacci car. And now it's Lando Norris that's chasing down that Boccalacci car. So DeForni into P4. Lando Norris still hasn't got past the car of Boccalacci. And that is the Boccalacci car that we look at now, or looked at then, Up the road, though, is the Allen car. With a margin now of 1.5 seconds in the lead, but Lando Norris now lining up the Dorian Bogalacci car, going into the Parabolica. So as they head up towards the hairpin now, absolutely flat out section goes side by side. The two of the cars heading together now. This is going to give Lando Norris the inside line as Max DeForney overtakes the Alex Gill car. And Lando Norris makes a short work of the car of Bocalacci there. So there you can see DeForney side by side with Gill then, and Bocalacci coming back at Lando Norris. So DeForney finds himself in the final podium place at the moment. As I say, he's taken two P2s out of the races so far, and now he'll be chasing down the Bartolomei Marecchi car from the BM Racing team. Well, within sights, within the 17 minutes that are remaining, and lock-up from Marecchi is only going to help DeForney's quest in trying to get on terms with that car. So there is our race leader. Goes through turn number one. There goes P2. Marecchi then running in P2. DeForney, as I mentioned, up into the final podium place now for P3. And Allen doing a good job out front by increasing by another few tenths the margin of comfort that he has between himself and Marecchi. It's now 2.1 seconds, the difference between the P1 and P2 cars, as you can see around the Parabolica then. And Max DeForney doing his level best to get on terms with Marecchi here, but not close enough to have a go. I wouldn't have said from that far back going into the hairpin. In the meantime, Lando Norris having a go and succeeding. He is now right behind DeForney, so Lando Norris up into P4. And again, the deposed driver of Alex Gill having a go back at Lando Norris. But Lando Norris, who's taken not only the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup Championship and did that in the last race, of course, last weekend, he took the Formula Renault 2-litre Euro Cup as well. Here it is in replay then, just a perfect execution of how you can use the hairpin. And the driver that was got there, good and proper, Alex Gill, because Lando Norris sorted that absolutely perfectly. So first 10 minutes of the race done, and the order is Allen, Marecchi, DeForney, and Lando Norris then the top four places, with Gill and Bocalacci P5 and P6. So they're then our race leader. Just lost out a little bit now, but Max DeForney is right on the back of Bartolomei Marecchi. So DeForney then will push now around the Parabolica and line up a move potentially as Robert Schwartzman is making his way back up the order once again and gets past the number 28 car of Finlay Hutchison. So Schwartzman then, who was turned around earlier on. But DeForney was definitely lining up Marecchi going into the hairpin. Now, whether he did manage to get past or not, we were taking a look at the Robert Schwartzman situation just as DeForney would have made it to the hairpin. So we're chasing down there is the car of Julian Falchereau. Into the stadium section of the circuit, the number one car of Jihan Daruvala. And trying to get on terms with the number 16 car there is Vartanian. Well, DeForney did get past Marecchi because DeForney is now P2, as you can see the order on the graphics on screen to the left-hand side. So Alan leads from Tafoni, from Marecki now. And Marecki will fall into the clutches of one Mr. Lando Norris. And that is the battle that you're looking at right now as Lando Norris reels in that Marecki car now, heading towards the hairpin once again. Here's our race leader, who Max Tafoni has got, what do we got? Just under 13 minutes left to try and claw back the 3 second margin that Alan has over Tafoni in P2 at the moment. And don't think it's beyond the realms of his possibility. Going through there in the number 14 car, Will Palmer. So we stay with Will Palmer being chased down by Vartanian, the Fortec Motorsports driver. About mid-distance in the race now as they go side by side. This is the battle that's going on for P11 and P12. Schwartzman there on the number 77 car of Lawrence Hoare. Fairness, that's Korniev, who is right on the back of the number 77 car now. Schwartzman just a bit back of that, and that in replay. Alan with 2.5 seconds margin over Tafoni. Now there is Max Tafoni going through. P3 then is Marecki, still being chased down by Lando Norris, the newly crowned champion in this series. Lando Norris not quite as close to Marecki as he was last time around. But over the second part of the Parabolica, heads towards the hairpin now. Marecki look a little bit squeamish onto the front of the tyre, but it was a big lock-up from Lando Norris, which any opportunity Lando Norris had to take advantage of the loose front end of the number 96 car, that unfortunately went awry by that huge lock-up from Lando Norris, who continues to push hard the number 96 car ahead, hoping to provoke a mistake and perhaps elevate himself into that final podium position. There's Max Tafoni chasing down the car of James Allen, that is leading. And there is Lando Norris, who's continuing to chase down the P3 car of Marecki. He also has Alex Gill for company in car number 27 there. And right behind Gill, it's Dorian Boccolacci in that machine. The orange and black number 9 car that you saw, Dorian Boccolacci then. Well, Tafoni has taken 3 tenths out of the gap to James Allen, but we're down to under 10 minutes of the race remaining now. Just for the moment, Marecki has seen off the challenge from Lando Norris. Lando begins to just try and reel in the car, but he's nothing like as close as he has been heading into this hairpin. How's Schwartzman doing? Up to P15 now, just tucked in behind the car of Korniev. So Schwartzman's opportunities for a podium are dim and distant, I'm afraid to say. Race leader, there is P2. Battle still going on for P3 as once again Lando Norris just turns up the wick a little bit and continues to put the pressure on the number 96 car ahead. Another lock up coming there from Bartlomei Marecki, the BM Racing Team liveried car, under pressure from the new champion Lando Norris. And now, again, time has been taken out of the lead. It's down to just 2.1 seconds between Allen and Forney. As Lando Norris just taking a sneaky look at the inside there, wasn't close enough to be able to do anything, but what he's wanting to do is just harry and worry the Bartlomei Marecki car ahead. And arguably, he's being hugely successful at that, because apart from a couple of lockups, Bartlemy has not made a mistake. Under 8 minutes remaining. Time running out for the moves to be made. Maybe six racing laps left in the race. Again, Lando Norris just taking a look at the inside, and this time he does go through on the inside, and Marecki is run wide there. He's going to have a really, really great commitment to stay with Lando Norris here, but now Lando Norris has got his nose in front. He moves into the final podium place. So Marecki pushed back now to P4. So it's Alan Dufourny and Lando Norris now, and fancying his chances is Alex Gill. Here's the replay then. It was from much, much further back, but able to carry more speed. So whilst Marecki ran very, very wide, there was no contact between the two of them, and Lando Norris gets the job done. OK, here comes P1 and P2. Last time around, it was 2.1 seconds, the margin between the two of them. It has come down by another 0.3, because it's now 1.8. But we only have 6¾ minutes left in the race. And then a real gaggle of cars lining up for P6, 7, 8, 9 at the moment. It's the car of De Sadalia. And there in replay is the car of Boccalacci, taken to the curbs and losing out on a number of places there. So the battle at the front then, which involves a margin of 1.8. And look how Lando Norris, now that he's got past the car of Bartlemy Marecki, is up the road, isn't he? Incredible pace. And big lock up there coming from the car of Jihan Darovala in car number one, the Josef Kaufmann racing machine. They're having a good race is Alex Gill. And side by side here, the number nine car of Dorian Boccalacci and the number one car of Jihan Darovala. And it's Darovala that runs really, really wide, but carries the momentum and carries the speed. But Dorian Boccalacci then breathes a sigh of relief and trying to buy into this battle as well. Was the car of Will Palmer, but Will Palmer getting it wrong and was out and into the gravel, so that will be the end of Will Palmer's race. That's cars not coming back from there, and this is how it happened. He was trying to buy into this battle, but then just got onto the painted lines, onto the Astro. Car starts turning around and stuck into the gravel, so that is the end of the Will Palmer race. It was a valiant effort to try and get on the back of that pack and have a go, but all ends in tears for Will Palmer, who is out now. So, out of the car he will get. His race done, dusted, and over. A safety car is being deployed for the Will Palmer car. So, that means that Alan, Dufourny, and Norris will all bunch up together. Now, with just 4 minutes left on the clock, I'm not absolutely convinced that they're going to be able to retrieve the Will Palmer car in 4 minutes, and therefore the race will most likely finish behind the safety car, which means the order will be Alan Dufourny and Norris to go up to the podium, I would think. So safety car standing by then to be released and to pick up the cars. So safety car out on track then to pick up the leading trio of Alan Dufourny and Norris. And I fear, as I said, with just 3.5 minutes left on the clock, however quick the recovery operation is for the stricken car that's out, that it's not going to be quick enough for us to get any racing in. And therefore the order will be Alan Dufourny and Norris. So there is the safety car, and there, the top three cars into the picture now, which will, of course, all bunch up together. And there is the Palmer car then, that is the car that's going to have to be recovered. And, well, as you can see with the clock at the top of the screen, they're counting down. Don't think it's very likely that we're going to see any more racing laps. And the 2016 season for the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup, as the recovery truck is on its way. But, of course, it already has the number 24 car of Izakian. So probably that recovery truck is just coincidental that we're seeing it. It's probably not being sent to this particular scene. Of course, there are lots of recovery trucks and recovery vehicles that are stationed all around the circuit. So cars all being led by the safety car. As I say, I think it will be a win for James Allen. It'll be a P2. It will be the third P2 for Tifone across the racing weekend. And just 1.5 minutes left on the clock, and can't see from we can just see from our commentary position that a recovery vehicle is on its way to the Will Palmer car, but I think we're going to run out of time. So cars making their way down towards the stadium section of the circuit. You can just see the change of tarmac there. That's where the drag strip here at Hockenheim ends. And just about to go past the stricken Palmer car. Well, to be fair to the recovery crew, they've done it pretty quickly. If they could get the safety car in at the conclusion of this lap, there would be one racing lap presumably left under the time allowed. So it'll be after be a quick execution of the safety car coming back in. But it is possible. Although the light's still flashing on the safety car now, it's going to complete another lap, which means that this is going to be the last lap. So the order then, Allen, Tifone and Norris with Marecki, Gill. Then it is in P6, Di Sadalia, Baptista, Boccolacci, Daruvala. And rounding out the top 10 is the number 16 car of Falchero. So final lap then behind the safety car. Presumably, at the end of this lap, the safety car will peel off and just allow the cars to take the checkered flag. Sure enough, safety car is going to come in at the conclusion of this lap. And that will allow the cars to at least take the checkered flag. And the 1-2-3 will be Allen, Tifone and Norris. So heading up towards the hairpin now. And just to add insult to injury, as you can see, the rain has started now. With the cars all out on slick tyres. There is Lando Norris, who is the champion. Double bubble in Formula Renault, having taken the Northern European Cup. Did enough in the second race to be able to achieve that title. And just a weekend ago, taking the Euro Cup championship at Spa-Francorchamps. So the cars head into towards the Sachs Curva. Lights are out in the safety car. That will peel off into the pit in. and it will just be one turn for the drivers to do before seeing the checkered flag. Of course, no overtaken until they're past the safety car line, but to all intents and purposes, it should finish the way the order sits at the moment, with Alan De Forney and Norris the 1-2-3, although De Forney clearly is going to have a go. So now they give it a footfall, and the checkered flag awaits. And it is Alan De Forney and Norris, the 1-2-3, with Marecki, Gill, and De Sadalia taking places to P6, with Baptista, Boccolacci, Daruvala, and rounding out the top 10, it is the car of Julien Falchero. So there we have it then, the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup race done and dusted, and ended really rather slowly, didn't it, behind the safety car. That brought about by the car stricken in the gravel. So James Allen takes the win. The final race of the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup here at Hockenheim, the final event, and their confirmation of the result. Alan De Forney, Norris, Marecki, Gill, De Sadalia, Baptista and Boccolacci, the top eight placed drivers. Then Jihan Daruvala, Falchero, Vartanian, Hur, Schwartzman made it back to P13. Valiant effort from him, having been turned around earlier. Alexei Korniev, Izagian, Fenestraz then, following the drive-through penalty for the jump start, ended up P16. With Finlay Hutchinson, Pankovic, Albury, Esbrook, Will Palmer, we lost, of course, and Enrique Chavez didn't even make the start. The car not going from the off, unfortunately. So there in replay then was the win going the way of Allen. Cars making their way back, podium to come. The 1-2-3, of course, up on the podium for the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup race here at Hockenheim, as everyone assembles below the podium, ready for that ceremony. Cars making their way into Parc Fermé right now. So the top three all are parked up and we'll be heading up to the podium shortly. Been congratulated by team members first of all. And then the short sprint up to the podium, where the trophies and champagne await. Been a big weekend of racing here at Hockenheim, and the final cars on the bill then, the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup cars. And here some of the well, in fairness, the top three in super slow-mo, taking P3, Lando Norris. P2 then, spirited drive from Max De Forney to take P2. But the winner, the number 18 car that you see middle of the screen right now for James Allen, for JD Motorsport, he takes the win. So we just await the podium. Here are some highlights to music right now. So some of the highlights then of the Formula Renault race, three of their races across the weekend. See the podium being ready now. The drivers are standing by, ready to be announced out onto the podium to collect their trophies. It's my friend Lucas up there doing the podium announcing. So Lando Norris then. And big hair, big driving skill. Max DeForney then takes P2. Here comes James Allen then to take the top step of the podium and the win in the final race of the 2016 season. JD Motorsport, of course, the team's represented up there on the podium. So national anthem plays out. Now it's time for trophy presentations. P3 first of all. Well, what a weekend Lando has had. What a couple of weekends Lando has had, having taken the two championships. Max DeForney then, as I said, a really spirited drive to take P2. And then to take the win, right on the top step of the podium. James Allen holds his trophy aloft. Congratulations to all three of them. Of course, the teams receive trophy as well. So JD Motorsports then. And of course, top rookie as well, double bubble for Lando Norris as he gets yet another trophy to add to his really rather burgeoning trophy cabinet. They all pose together for the photographs. Congratulations to the 1, 2, 3. Come to the front of the podium for further photographs. And then it is time for champagne, of course, to be sprayed liberally across the podium after a fantastic season. Thank you so much for watching the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup race. Hope you enjoyed it. See you very soon. Bye-bye for now.